Hey guys, welcome to another video here at Creators Theory. So in this video we'll see how to create a loom of a transition in Filmora. So by the way, we are using Filmora 10, so there might be not much difference between Filmora 9 and Filmora 10. And before starting this tutorial, if you're new to this channel, then do hit the subscribe button and follow for more Filmora related tutorials. So guys, let's get started with the tutorial. So in the first part, as you can see, I've added both the media and the bin. So in this video transition, we'll be using two videos. So what I will do, I will bring the first video, let's keep it 25, and I will bring the second video. So in the first part, we don't really need the first part of this video. So what I will do, I will go to the second part, and I need to come to the first frame of this second video. So as you can see, this is the first frame of the second video, and I will just click on snapshot. So what it will do, it will create a snapshot, and you will be able to see this snapshot if you go to by right clicking and go to the properties. We will be able to see where the snapshot has been stored, so you can download, you can use the snapshot there. And in the second part, we will see you using Canva how we need to remove the background of this image. So see you in second part. So as you can see guys, I am in Canva right now. So I will be using Canva to remove the background of this image. You can use any other free tool that you know of. Since I've already have a pro plan of Canva, that's why I'm using this one. So I will go to upload, and I will bring this image that I downloaded. So this is the first frame of this video, second video that we have. Now what I will do, I will adjust this to duality into 720, since that is the resolution of the video that we have. So once this is done, I will select this image and go to effects, and in effects I will select background remove. So Canva will do its thing, and it will automatically select this part as the central image and remove the background from it. So as you can see, the background has been removed. Now what you can do, you can go on download and click on transparent background, and then download. Okay, so this is the first part. So once we are done with this, let's go back into Filmora and import that. So as you can see, I've brought this image over here. So now what we will do, I have this image without background, so I will remove both of these first of all. And now I have this image. What I will do, I will go into media, sample colors, and green screen I will bring below this. Now let's see how it looks. As you can see, the image looks behind green screen. Let me just extract this a little bit and bring this to the start of the video. So as you can see, this video is around 8 seconds. So that's fine, we will edit it at the end. So what we'll do, we need to add a little effect to this. So I will double click on it, and here I will go into animation, and in animation you can select any of these animations. So these are the new animation that we have. So I will be not using these, because most of you, I don't know, you might be having these or not, but it would be easier to use these one in the video. So what I will do, I will use the, so let's see how this works. So yeah, this might be fine. So then click on OK. As you can see, the effect has been implemented. Let's just export this video, and once we are exported, I will meet you on the third part of this video. Hey guys, welcome back, and it's in the third part of this tutorial. We are in the third part. So as you can see, I've exported the green screen video as well. So now let's bring all of this together into the timeline. First, let me bring the first video, and let's keep it 1920 to 1080p, and then I will bring the video 2, as you can see over here. Enable timeline snap. Okay, and we are done over here. So I will decrease the size of this first video. I think it is too long. Let's keep it to 4 seconds and delete the middle part. And then let's bring the test video that we created. So as you can see, this has a little, so what we need to do before adding this, what we need to do, again take this video and second video and go to the first frame. And here, when you go to the first frame, just right click and click on add freeze frame. So this will give a huge freeze frame. Let's just edit, adjust this till maybe half a second. So we will adjust this and we will add it over here. So once this is done, we will go back to our video above. And since you know there is an ins pop in, and then there is a pop out as well. So what we'll do, we'll delete this, keep it this till here only, and cut the next part and delete it. So, and we will adjust this along with the freeze. So make sure you don't go beyond the freeze part, and you stay with the freeze part. If you go beyond, it will still carry on with the next video. So once we are done with this, we'll just click on this and select the green screen, select the color picker. Okay, let me just bring this over above it. I'll select again the green screen, the color picker, and we'll select this screen. So as you can see, let's play this now. So as you can see, the green screen effect. Let's just, in what we'll do, we'll increase this freeze frame, and we'll bring this over a little over here, and let's play once again. You can increase the freeze frame if you want, if you have a good amount of video, so you can increase that. And so as you can see, there is a hard cut over here where there is a direct jump from one video to another. So as you know, we need a luma fade transition in between these. So again, I will go to transitions, and here I will select we can go with color distance. So here I will go with color distance. Let me just bring this into the, and I will decrease this. So now let's see how this works. The image appears, there's a luma fade, and there is a video. So that's it guys with this tutorial on luma fade transition. I hope you guys like it. Surely I will be making a video on all the new and amazing features in Filmora 10, so stay tuned and subscribe to our channel if you're not yet. And if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up, and see you guys in another video. Till then, see ya.